we'll see the shear stress distribution in a next circular cross section. First we have seen triangular rectangular cross section. Now we'll see circular cross section. For that, consider a circle at a distance, this is the, consider a layer GH at a distance of y from the neutral axis. Y bar is the centroidal distance, and it is of radius r, and b is the width of the element. Now shear stress is given by 2 is equal to F into A into Y bar by IB. So what is A Y bar? A Y bar is equal to integral A Y. So we are going to consider an element of thickness dy at a distance of y from the neutral axis. So the area of the element will be B into dy. That is the area of the element. Element width is B, and depth is dy, thickness is dy. So A is equal to by dy. So multiplying by y, you will get Ay is equal to by dy. So integral of Ay dy is equal to what will be the integral limits? Limit will be above the area, above the layer GH. So area, that is, it is starting from y and it is reaching to r. So the limit will be integral y to r by dy. So from figure we can write it as r square minus y square is equal to b/2 the whole square. From this figure we can write it as b/2 the whole square. Consider the triangle, b/2 the whole square is equal to r square minus y square. So from that, substituting r square minus y square is equal to b/4. B square is equal to 4 into r square minus y square. So from that, differentiating both sides, we will get with the variables 2b into db is equal to 4 into, here the variable is y. So minus y square is minus 2y. So that minus we have taken here into 2y dy. So from that we will get y dy as minus b/4 into db. Now substituting that here, that is Ay bar is equal to integral y to r by dy. So here we have y dy is equal to this term. So substituting for y dy here, integral of b into minus b/4 into db. So when this y term we are converting to b term. So when y becomes in terms of b, what will be y? Here b is b. So when y becomes r, here b is 0. There is no width of the element, 0. So from limit 0 to, from b to 0. So when we are neglecting this, in order to remove this negative sign, we can write it as, we can change the limit from 0 to b, b/4 db. So integrating and putting the limits, we'll get it as 1/4 into b³/3 from 0 to b. That is, we'll get it as b³/12. So substituting this into equation 2, we will get it as F into Ay bar. Ay bar is b³/12 divided by IB. So we will get the equation as F into b²/12i. Now substituting for I, you can write it as, so that is for b square, you can write it as r square minus y square, or 4 into r square minus y square. We have from the before steps, we have f into b square as 4 into r square minus y square, because this b is only a assumed length. We have only r and y, so we need to convert in that terms, divided by 12i. So you will get it as f by 3i into r square minus y square. That is the general expression for shear stress for a circular section. So now for substituting, it will be again a parabolic variation. The variation will be again parabolic variation. So from when y is equal to 0, first when y is equal to say top, it is r. At neutral axis, y is equal to 0. So at neutral axis, when y is equal to 0, substitute y equal to 0, you will get it as f r square by 3i. F by 3i into r square. Similarly, for top and bottom, it will be y is equal to r. So substituting y is equal to r, you will get it as 0 and 0. So instead, for this I, we are substituting for I. I is f by r square. F by I for a circular section is pi into d raised to 4 by 64. D raised to 4 by 64 into r square. So here, when we are converting this terms, d as pi into d in terms of r is 2r the whole raised to 4 divided by 64. On simplifying, we will get it as 4 by 3 into f by pi r square. 4 by 3 into f by pi r square. That means which is equal to 4 by 3 into tau average. That is the average shear stress. 4 by 3 into tau average, because this is shear force divided by area of cross section. So 4 by 3 into tau average is the expression for a circular section. So the expression will be in this form. That is, it will be again a parabola with the maximum value as here, tau average. These both the top and bottom values will be 0. Okay, this will be the maximum value for tau average. Okay, this will be the maximum shear stress distribution for a circular section.